Friend Gene Magden. Okay, I have a question for the ladies in the room. You don't have to really answer, but you can raise your hand if you want to. How many of the ladies in the room were at one time or another secretly in love with Elvis Presley? Yep, I see a hand over there. And I'll bet some of you other ladies may be a little shy, but I'll bet almost every lady, how could you not be? I mean, not a lady, of course, but how could you not be? He was kind of like the Beatles, who just kind of burst on the scene. It was new and different, and he had a, you know, what's it called, panache or flair or charisma, and he could really sing, and he had a lot of very good songs, but he had one in particular that was probably his most famous of the love songs that he sang. So let me play that for you now. Thank you very much. Thank you. Nice singing with our little lady duet right in the middle here. Very nice. Now, when I grew up, which is in the 60s when I was a teenager, the Beatles were kind of like Elvis. They were new and different. They looked different. They dressed different. Their hair was different. They sounded different. And everybody my age, about 15 or so, wanted to be like the Beatles. So I was no different. I had kind of longer hair, and my parents bought me a drum set, and I played drums in a band and pretended I was Ringo and all this kind of stuff. And even now, I'm in my upper 60s, even now I still love Beatles songs and play Beatles songs and things like that. And kind of like Elvis, the Beatles had a lot of different kinds of music that they played. Some of it was very tender and beautiful, and other was more kind of hard and rock and roll and things like that. They definitely went through phases. This song was written by Paul McCartney, and Paul McCartney was probably the most popular of the Beatles. He was very cute, he was handsome, he had money, he had fame, he sang well, he was an amazing musician. And you think that, boy, that guy's just got it all. But he wasn't without his own problems, just like you and I have our own problems that we deal with. And this is a song that he wrote one night, or actually in the morning, after having a dream about Mother Mary, who came to him. And this is an interesting point, because no one's sure if Mother Mary was, like, you know, the real Mother Mary, or if it was his own mother who happened to be named Mary. But Mother Mary came to him and told him in his dream, everything's going to be okay. Let it be. Let's not worry about it now. Go on and enjoy your life. And he wrote one of the prettiest songs I think the Beatles ever wrote. Let me play it for you.
Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
Thank you. Now, I can only stay about 3 or 4 more hours, so I hope you're not in a hurry or anything, right? Actually, I'm going to play 2 more songs for you. This next one's also a Beatles song. And this Beatles song was written by George Harrison. George Harrison was kind of in the background because Ringo was the drummer and he would shake his head and do the drums. And Paul McCartney and John Lennon wrote the majority of the Beatles songs and they were very popular. And George was kind of the quiet one. He was called the Quiet Beatle. He was a very deep thinker. He was a philosopher. He was also an incredible musician. And he wrote a lot of really good songs. And this one in particular, I like to play because it's a song of hope for the future. And given what all of us have gone through over the last 18 months or so, it seems like things are getting a little bit back to normal. We're having music again and things of that nature. This is George Harrison's song. It's called Here Comes the Sun. Thank you. There's also a little mystery about that song, kind of like Let It Be. George never really said if the sun was like the sun, the star, or the Son of God. He was a very religious man, so he kind of didn't want to say, he just wanted to leave it up to you. You can interpret it any way you want to. to thank Bobby for inviting me to play for you. I hope that you've enjoyed yourself. I'm going to sing one last song by our friend John Denver. And a lot of people kind of feel it's almost one of their most favorite songs. So sing along. Have a little vodka before we sing. I dropped my cap. It's not really vodka. Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, rolling like a breeze. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. All my memories gather round her, miner's lady, a stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, a misty taste of moonshine, a teardrop in my eye. Ready? Let's sing together. Here we go. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country road, I hear her voice in the morning hour. She calls me, radio reminds me of my home far away. And driving down the road, I get a feeling like I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday, country road, take me home to the place I belong. Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country road, take me home. Down country road, take me home. Down country road. Thank you, everybody. I really enjoyed playing with you this morning. My name is Dr. Barry Trunk. I hope to see you again soon. I have two friends that play with me, so maybe next time we'll have a trio instead of a single act.
What you doing?
You nice people have a great afternoon. We'll see you again soon. Thank you for saying so. I appreciate that very much. By the way, it's free to come into the room. It's $5 to leave. Did we mention that? No? All right, we'll let it slide this time, okay. Have a great afternoon, everybody.
Yeah, you too.
Thank you.
Oh, Lordy, Lordy.